Introduction.
Today, topic is in related with the power of emotional intelligence. And we have selected this topic because we believe that this is one of the most important topic, being a student living together with another friends. Because living together with our friends, maybe 1 day, 2 day, 1 week is easy, but to live for a long time, it is really difficult. Because sometimes we lose our own emotion. Therefore, today we have decided to talk with this topic. So when we talk about emotion, actually, emotion has the two functions. One is constructive emotion and destructive emotion. We know what is destructive emotion. Anger, jealousy, hatred, misunderstanding. So those type of thought, when occurs in our mind, we consider them destructive emotion. As long as this type of emotion in our mind, and we are not happy ourselves, and our friend also not happy with us, we may start finding the faults in our friends. Even out of good situation, we will find faults. So this attitude heavily influence on ourselves and also the environment we are living. It will influence from one person to another. Finally, it counts to micro to macro. The micro means the one person, and when it goes to public, it becomes macro. Therefore, before happening something like this, so if we control our emotion, then we can minimize the certain kind of issues that appears with us that creates more understanding, more problems. So the antidote for the destructive emotion is constructive emotion. Of course, when we talk about the constructive emotion, it is difficult to improve. It is difficult to improve ourselves the constructive emotion than destructive emotion. When we feel angry, it's very easy. We easily feel irritated when our demands are not met. So if we can find a fault in every situation, then we can actually easily habituated with such kind of destructive thought and emotion. I thought my time is over. Long ago, I live with one of old monk. I think it is about in 2016. I live with that old monk for 9 years in Thailand. That old monk has so much habituated with the destructive emotion. So whenever he comes to the ceremony, so he will first see everyone like this. And we, about the 18 monks, we are scary about him. And he finally finds some fault. And he yelled at monks like this. And sometimes everything is okay. So we are waiting. He may be finding some fault. And we will shout again. So I have that experience about 9 years until he passed away in 2016. Yeah, it is very sad news. Yeah. With that old monk, out of 18 monks, only one monk can live. Even his disciple leave him because he angry so much. Only one monk can live. Who do you think? It was me. It was me. Whenever he shout at me, I laugh at big smile. He always say, doesn't understand. And finally, that old monk become good friend. That's he become good friend. So therefore, when we have such kind of positive emotion, even we can be a game changer. Actually, we can change the game from negative emotion, negative situation, to positive situation. That monk, initially angry monk towards everyone. Finally, he became good at me because I understood his emotion. So emotional intelligence means what, actually? We must master of the emotional intelligence. Is to master to know our own emotion. Control. Control. So by understanding our own emotion, we can understand other emotions. By understanding our own feeling, we can understand the feelings of others. So when we adapt with a selfish attitude, conceit, mana, then we tend to develop the negative emotion. Because when we are selfish, we grudge our own views and our own ideas, then we never try to understand the others. If we don't try to understand others, then the troubles occur simultaneously and problems never be solved. That is why the emotional intelligence means, actually in Buddhism, when we see the Buddhism, wisdom and knowledge. So when we talk the knowledge, it is IQ. We gain a knowledge IQ by reading books, by critical thinking, by listening the critical talks, by attending the seminars. This is IQ. When we have IQ, we have the brilliant mind. But when we develop the emotional intelligence, that is actually Buddhism we can say convert to the wisdom. Wisdom means the panya. So it is understanding in the deeper level of the emotion by ourselves and also others. Whatever I like, the Buddha said in Pali, attanang upamang kattva. So put myself on the feet of others, put my situation on the situation of others, then I can understand his situation well. So by this way, we can solve our problem, our own problem. Also, we can help others to solve their problems. And when we all have the improve the emotional intelligence, beside intelligent question, IQ, then we can all live together peacefully and happily. Thank you.